Now I'm going to show you the classroom management features built into Tinkercad.
You'll need to log in to tinkercad.com. Click sign in and choose sign in with Google. Add your username with @education.nsw.gov.au. When you log in to the Tinkercad dashboard, you'll see any designs that you have created. You'll also have access on the right-hand side to your profile, as well as changing the design tool that you choose to use. One of the things that I'd like you to notice is that as a teacher, you have access to an extra tab at the top called Classes. Here, you can actually see any students that you may have in your class, and you also have visibility over their work. So if you would like to create a class, you simply click on Create New Class, pop in a name, the grade, and a subject, and click Create. Now in my class, I can see that I've got 0 students. So by clicking on my test class, I can actually add students in a couple of different ways. I can manually add the students to my class by clicking on Add Students and adding in their name and a nickname and adding them into the classroom. I can also add a list of students as well. The easiest way is to use the class code. When I click on Class Code, I have a unique code that students can type in when they log into Tinkercad. You can also tag the link and email it directly to them, or pop it into an online learning management system for the students to be able to click on the URL and join straight away. This is definitely the easiest way to add students into your Tinkercad class. Once you have created your class and your students have joined, you can actually see your students, and you have the ability to add to your class, remove from the class, as well as when you select on them, you can actually see their dashboard as well. So from here, you can see the type of work that they've been doing, and you may choose to select something ready for printing. So if I was to click on this design, I can actually download from my teacher dashboard as a .stl file ready for 3D printing. So adding students to your class can really help streamline the workflow and increase visibility over what they are creating. If somebody adds themselves incorrectly into Tinkercad as either a teacher or a student, by clicking on their profile using the cog icon, you can actually change how they will be using Tinkercad. So if I'd actually selected student and I didn't see this classes tab, I can rectify that by going to my profile and then selecting the correct classification, and just click Save Changes. Under the Teach icon, I can actually assign lessons to the students. So if I would like to go and get a lesson plan, I might like to choose this lesson where they're recreating a pattern found in nature, and I can click Send to Students. And I can either get a link to copy them, that they can copy direct to this lesson, or I can insert it into Google Classroom that I may have set up already.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.